Thank you.
Dr. Hahn, the Green Growth Institute started just over a year ago. What progress have you made since it was established?
Well, as you may know, green growth is a new paradigm of growth as compared with the traditional growth model. This is a quality-oriented, low-carbon sort of growth model. And Global Green Growth Institute, GGGI for short, was established about a year and a half ago. And we have been trying to share Korea's experience in policy implementation on green growth with developing countries. So now we have presence in Brazil, Ethiopia, Indonesia, Cambodia, and Kazakhstan. So for an institution which has a very short history, we've been doing quite a good job, I think.
Yeah. And what you've been sharing, you said you've been sharing this with developing countries. In what specific ways? What kinds of things are you doing?
Korea has been implementing the green growth policy for the last three years. And this, as I said, is a totally different growth paradigm from the past. We are trying to promote growth and at the same time enhance climatic environmental sustainability. And no other country has done this so far, whereas Korea has been reaping good results from the implementation of this policy, that we want you to help and work with the developing country, because developed countries have capacity to emulate what we are doing without any great difficulty, but developing countries do not have domestic capacity. So we are trying to cooperate with them to show how Korea is carrying out green growth policy in order to deal with the problems.
So what kind of specific projects, specific programs?
Well, in case of Ethiopia, they are interested in water and hydroelectric, generating electricity. So in that area of water, we are working with them. Cambodia wants to have a basic framework, legal as well as administrative framework to set up green growth policy, so that we are also helping it. So different countries have different requirements, so we are working with the individual government tailor-made to their needs.
Now, I understand that one of the aims of the institute is to find ways to, the main aim is to spur economic growth without damaging the environment.
Yes.
How successful has Korea been, and have you seen any results in any of these other countries that you've been working in?
Well, since the start of Industrial Revolution 250 years ago, we heavily relied on quantity-oriented growth model, which makes full use of a lot of fossil fuels, creating huge problem for climate change. And we would like to change the system from quantity-oriented into quality-oriented growth model. So in that respect, this is just beginning. We haven't accumulated vast amount of experience during the last 3 years. We have accumulated some experience, but we think this is good experience to share with the developing countries. So for example, in case of Korea, we have identified 17 new engines of new growth under three different categories. The first one was green technology, such as new and renewable energy, energy saving industries, LED light diode, emitting diode, and also green cities, green housing. These are the sort of one category. The other category is fusion of technology between manufacturing and information and communication industry, application of robotics and nano industry, so on. So through this way, we've been trying to accumulate some amount of experience in expediting the growth in green area, clean growth, and we are sharing some of that experience with developing countries.
Are you planning to go into further other developing countries elsewhere?
This Global Green Growth Institute is headquartered in Seoul, but it is international in terms of the composition of the members of the board of directors. Although I am the chair, Nikki Nicola-Stern, the Stern Review Fame, is vice chair, and 16 out of 19 foreign board members. And so it is we are trying to internationalize our activity more and more in the future.
And what about financing?
Korean government initially supported this, but we are getting financial support from Denmark, Australia, Germany, Japan, and also they are under Abu Dhabi, UAE are also supporting our activities. So substantial portion of our financial finance comes from outside Korea.
What was your budget last year?
Last year it was, I think, about $10 million, US dollars. This year it will increase more.